is it? What will it be? Main what? Good morning. We're pre-recording again because we think that worked pretty good last week. I'd love to have your feedback about it. This is story time with Betsy McPherson and Don Wilson at the behind the scenes recording. We're at Center Presbyterian Church, and we love our kids so much we decided to do a story time for them. So first we're going to sing our Hello, Hello song because I'm so glad to have you. So it's a stand-up song. Light out because I can see things. Are any of you afraid of the dark? Well, you don't need to be because God is always there and He is light. On day two, God created the sky above the earth. Here's the earth. And God looked at what He created and He said, it's good. Look how pretty the sky is. Oh my, there's even some clouds in it. That was day two. On day three, God created the oceans. See the ocean here? How many of you like to go to the beach? I sure do. So there's the ocean, and here's some trees. We got lots and lots of trees. Tall trees, short trees. And He also created flowers. We all like flowers, don't we? So He created all the vegetation is what things that grow that are green is called. So all our vegetables and fruits and everything were created that day on day three. And on day four, God created the moon and the stars and the sun. God created the moon so we could see at night. Now the sky's light, but it's usually dark when the moon's out, isn't it? And here's lots of stars. How many of you have been able to look up at the sky and see all the stars? There's millions of them, isn't there? Can you count them? No, but God can count them. So I'm going to put a whole lot of stars here. And you know what else He created? He created the sun. And there's the sun. And the sun is by day and the moon's by night. night. And at nighttime, you can see because of the moon and the stars. They light up the sky. But during the day, we need to see better, so he gave us the sun. And he saw that it is good. Then, on day 5, God created the birds and the fish. So I have some birds. I have some swans that swim in the water. A big old bluebird to sit in the tree. Some fishies for the sea. And some more birds to fly through the air. He said, when he looked at what he created, and he said, it is good. On day 6, God created animals and people. Wow. And he created so many animals. He created, I'm going to put them up in the sky so you can see them. Sheep, snakes, frogs, little kitties, little bunnies. He created the monkeys, puppies, look, that puppy's so cute, he's begging, tigers, and wolves. He created them all, and he looked at them, and he said they were good. And you know who else he created on day 6? He created people, and he saw that they were good. And on the 7th day, God rested, which is why we all try to rest on Sunday. So that's our story about creation. How many of you knew that story before? I bet a lot of you did. Okay, I'm going to take all these down. And we're going to sing a song. This sounds like it.
Yeah. whenever you're scared, you can always remember that God is in charge of everything, and he will always, always take care of you. Because remember, the first story the first week was about Jesus loving you. Okay, now we're going to go to Wally Weather. What's the weather today? Look outside. Is it winter? Is it cold and snowy? No, it's starting to warm up, I think. Finally. I'm ready for some spring weather, aren't you? Have to get a snow hat if it was winter, wouldn't we? How about, is it summer? Is it really, really warm out? Is it hot out? Are you going to the beach? No, he's all ready to go to the beach, isn't he? What he has on there. Is it fall when you need a jacket? No, but you sometimes need a jacket in the spring, too. It's spring, and I think some people might need a jacket today. I wore one, but I don't think I really needed it that much. We're going to put a jacket on Wally in case it's colder where he is. And we're going to put long pants on him, too, because I think he needs his long pants. And you always have to wear a hat. Keep the sun out of your face, off your face and out of your eyes. He might need a raincoat later. He needed one yesterday, didn't he, or Thursday. Boy, it really rained at my house on Thursday. So there we go. There's Wally. And we'll say we may see some sunshine. And we may see some clouds. I don't think it's going to be as windy as it was. It was so windy. I think it'll just be partly cloudy again. Maybe with a chance of rain. Oops, one of my clouds fell. Oops. Raindrops are fat at the bottom, not at the top. There we go. So that's what the weather's going to be. So that's what Wally's predicting today. Next week, we're going to learn about this, a rainbow. So you can all ask Mommy if they know, Mommies and Daddies, if they know about the rainbow story. Okay, now I have a new song for us to learn, and it's called We Are the Dinosaurs, and it's a stomping, stomping song. And since God made the dinosaurs too, even though they're not around anymore, we're still finding their bones, so God definitely made them. So we're going to put We Are the Dinosaurs on. So that'll change things. I'll get this. There's my thermometer. Clean up some so you can be ready for the next thing on the felt board. We may have to edit some of this. Thank you.
marching, marching. We are the dinosaurs. What do you think of that? We are the dinosaurs. Marching, marching. We are the dinosaurs. We take the world flat. We make the earth flat. We stop and eat our food when we're in the mood. We stop and eat our food on the ground. We stop and eat our food when we're in the mood. We stop. And
And The Three Bears is a really old book. Look, it's missing half of its page on the back. And since the libraries aren't open, I couldn't go get one. But I can still read the book. I like this best of those three because look at the nice little bear family. They're fuzzy and everything. Once upon a time, there were three bears. The father bear was great big. The mother bear was middle-sized, and the baby bear was wee little. One morning, the mother bear made some porridge for breakfast. She filled a great big bowl for father, a middle-sized bowl for herself, and a wee little bowl for the baby bear. Look how cute his little belly is. I think this is the cutest book. While the porridge was cooling, because they couldn't eat it, it was too hot, the bears went out for a walk in the woods. When they were gone, a little girl named Goldilocks came to their house and knocked on the door. No one answered. This was her first mistake. She went right in. She shouldn't have done that. Goldilocks saw the three bowls on the table. The porridge smelled so good, she decided to taste it. First, she tasted the porridge in the great big bowl. It was too hot. Ow, 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 ow. Next, she tasted the porridge in the middle-sized bowl. It was too cold. Blah. Then she tasted the porridge in the wee little bowl, and it was just right, and she gobbled it up. She liked that. Goldilocks saw three chairs in the living room. She sat in the great big chair, and it was too hard. Next, she sat in the middle-sized chair, and it was too soft. Then she sat in the wee little chair, and it was just right, but it broke as she sat down. Oh, dear, said Goldilocks. This is not good at all. She shouldn't be doing that, should she? Goldilocks went upstairs and found three beds. She was tired after her walk in the woods, so she decided to take a nap. Who would take a nap in somebody else's house? First, she lay down on the great big bed. There's the great big bed. It was too hard. Then she lay down in the middle-sized bed, and it was too soft. Then she lay down on the wee little bed, and it was just right. She closed her eyes and was soon fast asleep. Uh-oh. A little while later, the three bears came back to the house. They could tell that someone had been there. She even left a door open. Someone has been tasting my porridge, said the father in his great big voice. Someone has been tasting my porridge, said the mother bear in her middle-sized voice. And someone has been tasting my porridge and has eaten it all up, cried the baby bear in his wee little voice. Oh, poor baby bear. Look, he has a cute bowl with bears on it. Those poor bears. Look how unhappy they are. Mother bear looks a little bit afraid, doesn't she? The three bears went into the living room.
Someone has been sitting in my chair, said the father bear.
Someone has been sitting in my chair, said the mother bear. And someone has been sitting in my chair and has broken it all to pieces, said the wee little bear. Oh, poor little bear. He didn't get any porridge and now his chair is broken. Then the three bears went upstairs.
Someone has been sleeping in my bed, said the father bear.
Look, she messed it all up. Someone has been sleeping in my bed, said the mother bear. And someone has been sleeping in my bed, and she's still here, cried the baby bear. Goldilocks opened her eyes and saw the three bears standing over her. Oh, dear, Goldilocks said. She jumped out of the bed and ran downstairs and out of the door. And she never came back again to that house. She shouldn't have ever gone into anybody's house, should she, without them being there, unless you're invited. if, you know, you're really good friends with them or something. You don't go into people's house. Now, I have another book to read to you. Sorry. And it's about a little blue truck, because our color today is blue. Now, Little Blue Truck is a very nice truck, you'll find out. But he meets somebody that's not so fine. Let's see what happens. Horn went beep, engines purred, friendliest sounds you ever heard. Little Blue Truck came down the road. Beep, said Blue to the big green toad. Look at the big green toad. Toad said croak and winked an eye. When Little Blue Truck went rolling by, Toad says, hi. Sheep said, bah. Cow said, moo. Oink, said a piggy. Beep, said Blue. He always says hi, doesn't he? Cluck, said a chicken, and her chick said, beep. Ma, said a goat. Blue said, beep. Nay, said a horse. Quack, said a duck. Beep, said the friendly little blue truck. Here's a rude one. Honk, yelled a dump truck. Coming through, I've big important things to do. I haven't got time to pass the day with every duck along the way. Squawk, says the duck. He almost got run over. That's not nice. Vroom, went the dump truck around the curve. He saw a puddle. He tried to swerve. Into the mud rolled the big fat truck, and his big important tires got stuck. His heavy-duty dump truck tires were sunk down deep in muck and mire. Honk, cried the dump, and he sounded scared. But nobody heard or nobody cared. Then into the mud, bump, 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 came the little blue truck to help the dump. The little blue pushed with all his might. Now Blue and the dump were both stuck tight. Oh no, what's going to happen now? Help, 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 cried the little blue truck. Beep, 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 I'm stuck, I'm stuck. Everybody heard that beep, beep, beep. The cow came running with the pig and the sheep. There's the cow and the pig and the sheep, and they're all coming to help somebody, aren't they? They're helping their friend. Up at a gallop came the big brown horse. Goat jumped over the fence, of course. The hen came flapping with the chick and the duck, and everybody pushed with the little blue truck. Head to head and rump to rump, they all pushed Blue, who pushed the dump. They couldn't quite budge that heavy load. Then who hopped up but the big green toad? He's showing his muscles and look at his teeth. Frogs don't have teeth. That's pretty funny. All together, one, two, three. One last push and the trucks were free. Whoops, almost dropped a book. Yay. Thanks, little brother, said Dump to Blue. You helped me, and they helped you. Now I see a lot depends on a helping hand from a few good friends. So see, it's nice to help people, and the dump truck learned his lesson, didn't he? Well, beep, said Blue. Who wants a ride? Everybody scrambled to jump inside. Oink, quack, bah. Moo, cluck, peep. Nay, croak, ma. Beep, beep, beep. Isn't that a nice little book? Blue saved the day, didn't he? He helped the truck dump truck. Now, we're going to read a pigeon book. Because a pigeon book, he wants to drive a bus. Have you ever read pigeon books? They're pretty fine. This pigeon can be very persuasive. Hi, I'm the bus driver. Listen, I've got to leave for a little while, so can you watch things for me until I get back? Thanks. Oh, and remember, don't let the pigeon drive the bus. the bus driver.
Ah, there's that pigeon, he says. I thought he'd never leave.
Hey, can I drive the bus?
He's at it right away.
Please?
I'll be careful.
Oh, listen, he'll be careful. I'll tell you what, I'll just steer. My cousin Herb drives a bus almost every day. He's pretty talkative, isn't he? True story. Vroom, 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 vroom. Pigeon at the wheel. No? I never get to do anything. Oh, poor pigeon. We're not going to let him drive the bus, are we? Poor pigeon, though. He looks pretty sad, doesn't he? Hey, I've got an idea. Let's play drive the bus. I'll go first. Come on. Just around the block. Should we let him? I'll be your best friend. How about I give you $5? No fair. I bet your mom would let me. What's the big deal? I have dreams, you know. It's just a bus. Fine. Do you ever say fine to your mom when she says you can't do something? Let me drive the bus. The pigeon is just having a fit, isn't he? Oh, he's so frustrated. Now he's really sad. I'm back. You didn't let the pigeon drive the bus, did you? Great. Thanks a lot. Bye. Pigeon didn't get to drive the bus. Hey.
Uh-oh. He's got his eyes on a fire truck. Or no, a tractor trailer truck. You think he can drive that tractor trailer truck? I don't think so. Hey, you know, I think I might hear the school bus. Let's get the school bus on.
Wheels on the bus. We all like that song, don't we?
Some of us say, I love you. supposed to take off. I see some kitties. The kitties on the bus go meow, meow, meow.
Meow, meow, meow. Meow, meow, meow.
The kitties on the bus go meow, meow, meow. All through the town. Who else is on this bus?
A puppy.
I see a puppy. Puppies on the bus go woof, woof, woof. On the bus go woof, 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 all through the town. Is your favorite animal riding on this bus today?
Let's have dinosaurs.
Yeah, sing about it. Here we go. The
dinosaurs on the bus go
roar, roar, roar.
Brown bear song. So think about counting to three, look around for colors blue, and see if you can find.
Songs frequently mentioned on the web include brown bear, what do you see? The brown bear.
I don't know why she has to do that. Think about threes and think about letter C. Okay, things that start with C, and don't forget, it's a pretty tricky letter. Number three, letter C, color blue, shape, circle. There's lots of circles around too, isn't there? Okay. I got a big book for this one. Finally. Sound down because of that lady. Okay. We have it on the felt board too.
See?
Thank you for coming to story time. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed giving it to you. Please let me know if there's anything I can do to help you. I love you guys. Bye.